Hey there, I'm Angela Sharp, and welcome to the Daily Mix. You guys know what's happening this coming weekend? It's the Great Forest Park Balloon Race and Balloon Glow. And if you know me, you know I'm a little bit obsessed with this. I'm gonna call it a holiday. It's a holiday for me. So I started going when I was a little kid. I went with my mom and my dad and my grandparents and my brother and my sister, and we would sit across the street from where the balloons take off. And then of course, my dad and we would all jump in the car and kind of chase the balloons. Now, you know, a lot of these balloons aren't from St. Louis, so they don't know the streets as well as we did. So my dad and I would chase them. And then when you get there, they kind of help you, like let you help them land a little bit because their street team isn't there yet. So they'll have you hang on the balloon, you know, kind of weigh it down, or maybe even roll up the actual balloon part, which is so much fun. I'm showing you some pictures of me and my dad. You know, over the course of time, people started, you know, dropping out. You know, mom no longer comes with us, my brother no longer comes with us, my sister no longer comes with us, but dad and I go every year to the balloon glow and to the balloon race. In fact, one year I was working for the St. Louis Blues and we had a meeting and I had to be at the Blues game, but the race was going on. So I went to my meeting. After my meeting, I ran outside. Dad picked me up. We drove, chased the balloons, helped one land. He dropped me back off just in time for puck drop. Like, I'm seriously obsessed. So for one year, my parents gave me a balloon ride, not in the Great Forest Park Balloon Race. That's still on the bucket list. I want to go up with everybody. And I also have my little balloon necklace. So I'm totally stoked because Jessica Stegen is here with us today. She is the Director of Communications and Event Production over there at the Great Forest Park Balloon Race. So if you're unlike me and not already familiar with this, she's gonna tell you everything you need to know about it. It is a great family-friendly event. It's great if you don't have a family and they're just a crazy person like me. So she's gonna tell you everything you need to know. Let's get started on today's Daily Mix. Have big plans this Friday night. You know I do. I'm going to the Balloon Glow. Well, after that concert or event wraps up, head out to the Del Mar Loop and bask in the afterglow. Starting at 10 p.m., the Loop's destination restaurants and other hotspots will be offering all kinds of food and drink specials so you can keep the fun glowing. At the afterglow in the Loop is this Friday, September 20th. You can find a list of all the businesses and their specials at visittheloop.com. Mind, body, and soul, that's the theme of the Licensed Collections Office Senior Forum Series that's this Friday. Seniors can come on out and enjoy a free breakfast and a variety of presentations, a question and answer session, free cholesterol screenings, and giveaways. 95.5 The Loop's evangelist Mary Tillman will also be making a special appearance. The Mind, Body, and Soul Forum will take place this Friday, September 20th, from 8 to 12:30 at the Monserio Event Center on Olive. You can register for the event by calling 314-622-4643 or emailing hopkinsa@stlouis-mo.gov. Now, in honor of National Falls Prevention Awareness Day on September 23rd, the St. Louis Area Agencies on Aging will hold their first ever 1 million steps to prevent falls. This campaign, they're looking for partners to organize community walking groups and host events on that day and throughout September to raise awareness about older adults' falls and the simple things we can do to prevent them. Businesses, nonprofits, nursing homes, families, or groups and friends, anyone is welcome to partner up and participate. Walks can be held just about anywhere, city sidewalks, parking lots, walking tracks, malls. If you're interested in organizing a walk, you can contact the St. Louis Area Agency on Aging on Facebook or Twitter, slaaa.org. Now, this weekend, the Manhattan Antique Marketplace will host the first ever Big Apple Fest. The family-friendly event is centered on all things old, collectible, or handmade. There will be more than 200 vendors, live music, and a variety of food and drinks available for purchase. St. Animals Pet Adoption will also be there with cats and dogs looking for their forever homes. The Manhattan Antique Marketplace is located on St. Charles Rock Road in St. Anne. The Big Apple Fest will take place Saturday, September 21st from noon to 5. For more information, visit mamstl.com. Now, a new show is coming to Classic 107.3, The Voice for Arts in St. Louis. That'll be happening later this week. Musical Ancestries will teach school-age children about music, traditions, and cultures of other countries. This first episode will focus on music, culture, and storytelling traditions of West Africa. A grant from the PNC Foundation through PNC Arts Alive made this program possible. It debuts Saturday, September 21st at 10 a.m. Images, maps, and more will be available online for kids to use as they follow along with the broadcast. Everything you need to know can be found at classic1073.org. Now, did you know you could get fit for free in Keener Plaza? Well, you can. The Gateway Arch Foundation is hosting two health and wellness series throughout the second week of October. Every Tuesday through October 8th, you can start your morning off right with sunrise yoga, led by Yoga Buzz instructors. The Rise and Shine Flow starts at 7 a.m. and is open to all levels of experience. Now, on Wednesday through October 9th, you can unwind with some serious sweat. That's right, Heath Norton, the owner of Title Boxing Club in Rock Hill, will lead you through an hour-long boot camp featuring bodyweight exercises and individual and partner workouts beginning at 5:30. Let me tell you, he's not playing around. He will work you out. I've had the experience of doing one of those one-hour trainings with him. Crazy, but it's awesome, and it gets the job done. Both the Sunrise Yoga and Boot Camp classes are free and open to the public. You can find details about these events and more at archpark.org. Now, last week, more than 1,000 high school students in St. Louis public schools received free mobile devices and wireless internet as part of Sprint's 1 million project. This is the third year the district has been part of the project, which aims to help close the homework gap that puts students without home internet access at an academic disadvantage. SLPS students were some of the first in the nation to be part of the program when Board Alderman President Lewis Reed first introduced it to the district in 2017. Here's some of what he had to say at last week's event.
I am just so thankful that Sprint created this program, I guess, about 3 years ago. And, you know, they kept with their word in terms of providing free, unlimited access to the internet, helping to reduce what we call the homework gap, right? Because more and more what we see across the country, not just here in St. Louis, but across the country, teachers are given homework that truly require you to have access to the internet to finish it to the level that you need to finish it to be competitive in class. So I am so thankful that Sprint has continued to do this, and which is why I keep my service, Sprint service. So my bill is due today. By the way, hopefully they can give me a break on it.
All right, you guys know I'm so excited about our guest today. I've been looking forward to this for so long. Great Four Spark Balloon Race, Jessica Stegen is here with me.
Hi.
I'm so happy to have you here.
Thank you so much. We're so excited for this weekend.
This is going to be so great. So this is the 47th year.
It is, yes. And it started 47 years ago with 6 balloons, and this year we'll have 60 balloons on Central Fields, and I'm hoping all of St. Louis will come out to join us.
I love this. Well, I kind of talked a little bit about how I'm kind of obsessed with this event, but for somebody who might, you know, not know about it,
sure.
Can you kind of give them a little bit of a lowdown on what
of
it is?
Of course, yes. It's a perfect family-friendly event, great for families and great for friends who are like family to just come out and enjoy a day at Forest Park. We are back at Central Fields this year, which is towards the Upper Muni Lot and the Jewel Box. It's on that side of the park. There's a ton of free parking nearby on the streets and on the parking lots throughout Forest Park. But you can come out Friday as early as 5 p.m. We'll have food trucks, concessions, activities from all of our sponsors, and you can get there and get ready for the glow, which will start around 7 p.m. So our balloonists will load in on Central Fields and start to inflate around 7 p.m. as the sun is setting. It's a beautiful scene.
It's gorgeous. I mean, because a lot of times, I guess somebody sounds an alarm, and some of those guys will all glow at the same time.
Right, we have a train horn that we sound every 3 minutes. Once all the balloons are inflated, when they hear that train horn, they all fire their burners at the same time, and they all glow like fireflies, and it is just spectacular.
It's beautiful. Now, I'm gonna date myself here, but I remember with my parents, used to be able to drive by the glow. Mm-hmm. Now, not so much. Now you kind of have to park and kind of walk and get out.
Right.
But it makes it a much more fun kind of all day activity.
Yes, yes. Over the 47 years, we've touched just about every field in Forest Park. And being at Central Fields is special because you can sit and picnic. You can bring your own coolers. You can bring your own food. And you can enjoy the whole evening or the whole day on Saturday. And if the wind conditions are right and the weather conditions are right on Friday night, we will let the rope line down and you can actually walk amongst the balloons and meet the pilots and talk to them about all of their experiences. They come from all over the United States. They fly all over the world. These are some of the most elite hot air balloon pilots around.
Yeah, and it's so awesome. And they have to be elite, obviously, because they're going up with all these other balloons and they're landing now with, you know, when my dad and I chase, not a whole lot of other people chase, but now when we chase, thousands of people are chasing with us. So that's, you know, a lot for them to look out for.
Right.
On Saturday, though, for someone like me who has always stayed on the other side of the fence, there's a lot more going on in the park than just the balloons taking off.
Right. We start Saturday at noon, and we have our Enterprise Family Picnic Area where you can come find a spot and, again, bring your own soft-sided cooler, bring your own cans. It truly can be a free event for everyone to attend. And we have all of our sponsors, like PNC Bank, who's our presenting sponsor. They bring out this enormous mobile learning adventure where children of all ages can try on different uniforms or outfits to fit the career that they think they would like and take photos and really learn about banking. I mean, that's changing so much right now, and families can really learn about that together. Phillip 66, who actually, they fuel our chase crew. So each balloon has a chase crew that leaves the field as soon as their balloon launches, and they will follow and help them pack up. But you're right, we do have lots of people throughout the neighborhoods or who do help chase who can come help pack up the balloon, and it's such a wonderful experience.
It is. I was thrilled to have you come on because this is like the thing my dad and I do together, and it's, you know, it's meant so much to me since I was little to now.
Right.
So like, why not keep it going and continue on? But there's so much to do that people can find out. I know you have like a schedule. Where can people find out the schedule so they know what time they want to show up?
Sure. Everything is at greatforestparkballoonrace.com. And if you follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, we'll be updating throughout the day. So the thing about the race is we open at noon. There's festivities all day. We have skydivers who launch at about 3 o'clock, and we do an opening ceremonies right after that. And the balloons start to inflate around 4, and then our hair balloon, which is the PNC Bank balloon, will launch first, likely at 4:30, as long as wind conditions are correct. They get a 15-minute head start, and they land and lay out an X. And everyone else, we call it a hare and hound race. So the PNC balloon is the hare, everyone else are hounds, and we have 4 rounds of hounds that will launch in different sessions, and they try and drop a birdseed bag as close to the X as possible, and that's how they win the race.
That's how they win the race. But really, it's a win for everybody because you get to see, what did you say, 60 balloons up in the sky. And if you love balloons like I do, that's pretty cool. And if you're a little kid, any little kid loves to see all these balloons going up at once.
It truly is spectacular. And to be on the field right by the balloons, I mean, we have a rope line because they are FAA regulated, you know, for flight that day. But you can get right up close to the balloons, and it is just such a sight. It's one thing to see them on TV or in the sky, but to see them up close and personal, you know, 90 feet above you is just beautiful.
It's gorgeous. And I know that you've been involved for the last couple of years now. What has been your favorite memory of being a part of the Great Forest Park Balloon Race?
I did go on a flight once with some of our media partners.
And it? During the race?
Well, I haven't flown in the race, but it was before the race as we were preparing. I was able to do an interview 1,000 feet in the air, which was super fun.
That's awesome.
Because these pilots are such experts, it was so fun to see how they would land. And he landed, you know, right in a neighborhood on a dime. And just to hear the families come out and to be able to talk about the race and have the pilot share his experiences, I think that's the thing. It's the family traditions, whether it's like you with the chase crews or it's someone who comes to the field every year and collects the pins. We've had so many folks who have shirts that their dad wore with all all the pins from all 47 years. I mean, it's just so many family traditions.
Love it.
And it's a great way to start new ones or to continue old ones with your friends.
I love it. I really could talk to you all day long, but I think we're running out of time. Yeah. Tell everybody where they can find out just all that information one more time, because I know you guys want to plan for this. And although, you know, she's been saying, you know, things start at, you know, five or whatever, you want to get there early. Right. Forest Park is a great place to park and hang out, but a lot of people come to this event, so
that's
make sure
true.
You can park.
Right. Plan ahead. Go to GreatForestParkBalloonRace.com. We have maps there of the event space. We'll have maps where all the parking is and where the road closures are. We try and close as few roads as possible to help people get as close as they can to the field itself. But it's good to plan ahead. Think about what exit you're going to take. Think about your timing and pack a picnic.
Pack a picnic and make a whole day of it. I'm telling you, I would not lie to you. A great event. Definitely check it out. Jessica, yes. Thank you so much for joining
you
today.
Thank you.
Great to have you here. You guys, make sure you keep it right here on STL TV after you follow them. And you don't definitely want to follow them, especially for the race,
right?
Because sometimes the wind conditions take a minute, and they're really good about updating you. Like, oh, we're not going to go now. We're going to try again in 20 minutes or 30
minutes. Sometimes there are a few delays. We always launch between 4:30 and 6. That's the best time. And we do often post where the balloons are headed, depending on wind conditions.
Yeah, so definitely check them out. It's made it easier for stalkers like me. So definitely check that out. And you can always follow us on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram. You can drop us a line at thedailymix@stltv.net. We want to hear from you. That's going to do it for The Daily Mix. But keep it right here and experience St. Louis.